Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison. I'm a senior cloud advocate inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI. And what I want to start to explore in this video is the concept of views inside of Django. Now, one thing that we want to understand about any web framework, regardless of which one it is that you're working with, is it's like creating really any other type of application. That if you think about, for example, a phone app, when a user taps on a button, then what's going to happen behind the scenes is that your code is going to run some method, it's going to run some function. And that's exactly what happens whenever you're working with any web framework, and Django is no exception. So what we then need to do, in essence, is we need to create that function or that method that our application is going to call. We then need to make sure that we wire it up. Since we don't have a button, we need to explain to the framework, hey, when a user does this, this is the function that I want you to call. And then we need to determine what it is that we want to display out to the user. So three steps there. Create the function that we want to have called. Make sure that our framework knows when to call it based on some user action. And then determine what it is that we want to return out. Now, I'm going to, in this video, take a look at how we can set up the function and how we can set up what we're going to display out. In a later video, in the next video actually, we're going to explore how we can tell our framework, hey, when a user does this, this is the function that I want you to call. So what I've done here is I've opened up the little starter project. I'm inside of my Rela Cloud app, and I'm inside of the provided views.py file. And this is what you'll see inside of any app that you create inside of Django that first time is this empty views. So it tells us create your views here. Let's follow those directions. Now, there's actually two ways that you can create views inside of Django. You can either do this with a class or you can do this with a function. Let's start with a function. So I'm going to create one called index here, which is typically what you're going to call whatever that default page is. And then I'm going to say return render. And then the request object that we got that contains everything from the user. And the name of the HTML page that I want to return back. So let's call this index.html. Let's go in and create another view. Let's go ahead and say maybe the about page. So we'll say def about, and then it's the exact same thing. We accept the request object. That's all the information from the user. And then we return back the results of this render command, which is going to take our request and then the name of the HTML file that it's going to display. Now, the HTML file that it's actually going to display is going to be, in Django terms, what's known as a template. And as we're going to see a little bit later, we can actually make this dynamic. But it could just be a static HTML page, that if that's all that you need to display out, then that's it. So let's see how we could do that. Inside of my Rela Cloud app folder, I'm going to create a brand new folder that I'm going to call templates. And in here, I'm going to create my index.html. And then I can just go ahead and create a normal HTML file. So HTML, head, title, Rela Cloud, like that. Close our title, close head. Open up our body, and I'm going to go ahead and cheat here and just paste in a bit of text. So let's go ahead and just paste that in. There we go. Close out the body, and then close out our HTML. Cool. And I can do the exact same thing with the about page. So let's actually just copy all of that, and let's create another template here called about.html. And let's just paste that in here. So we'll update our title maybe to be about Rela Cloud. And then we'll update our text again. I'm just going to cheat here. And let's just grab that bit of text. There we go. And so what we now have is we now have our templates here. Again, right now they're just static HTML, but as we'll see a little bit later, you'll be able to make these dynamic. We've got our normal HTML head, title, body, just like we would for our index and for our about. And we've got our couple of views created. And so when index is called, it's going to return back that index HTML page. When our about is called, it's going to return back the about HTML page. Of course, the next step is to tell Django, to tell the framework, hey, when a user requests this, this is what I want you to do in response to actually connect those. And that's actually what we're going to see in the next video.